13-year NFL vet Ephraim Salaam. And Ephraim, we are going to start a weekly tradition around here.
Okay.
For you. For you. Yeah.
Mama, I made it.
Look, yes. Listen, this
Please,
is what I'm saying.
He's still
I'm
great.
Say this is a real stat. Because the numbers are what the numbers are. He looked very uncomfortable in the pocket. There's no protection up front from the offensive line. They have no real weapons outside. Gronkowski and Julian Edelman cannot
do it. What quarterback can play like that?
Look, all I'm saying is the way this man is looking right now, it's real mortal.
Racism is in the NFL. It's rampant.
The last I checked, they're not shooting black people on the field. All right, so let's not get it. Let's not get it misconstrued. I understand what you're saying, but the fact of the matter is, these are young black lives and young minority lives being shot down by people of authority, people we pay to protect us. You really want to compare that to having a black owner or a black coach? We're talking about a loss of life.
Let me open up right here, okay?
That's enough.
That's a bunch of bull stat, okay? First of all, that hit was a cheap shot.
That was not a cheap shot.
The hit on Nick Foles had no bearing on the outcome of the play. The play was actually almost over. Ball carrier down. He hits him after the ball carrier was down. Mm-mm. That's how you get people hurt. That's why the NFL implemented the rules where you can't take shots like that.
At this point, you could play quarterback for the Denver Broncos. Their defense is so good, so dominant. If we look in and see what Peyton Manning was unable to do last year, turning the ball over, 17 interceptions in 10 games, like they don't need Mark Sanchez to go out there and be an offensive juggernaut. They just need him, like you said, to manage the game.
I feel like this is a representative of a large portion of NFL players with those tweets.
I don't think so, and I really hope not. You know, that's a representative of someone's ignorant, who's unaccepting. Not too long ago, they were saying that about African-Americans across the board in all sports. Right? That we didn't belong there. I would believe that us as a society, we've gone past that.
How can it be where you can go and you can murder unarmed citizens and nothing happened to you? Like, what part of America is that? Especially athletes can't sit back and allow mistreatment to happen. They have to take a stand. It was very rare for someone in the NFL to do it because the NFL, they don't want anything disparaging towards the Shield.
All right, that's the bullshit. And I'm glad Jason Peters went over there and stood up for his quarterback, all right?
Are you going to pay that fine for Jason Peters?
No, the quarterback will. The quarterback will. I'll do it 100 out of 100 times. If someone hit my quarterback like that, especially outside the realm of the play, then we got a situation.
I can tell you
I'm
this,
I'm coming
though.
To see you. And when we want to talk about our great quarterbacks, we want them to pull those S's off their chest and be superheroes. He's not being a superhero right now, and it's not all his fault. It's the organization by not putting the weapons around him that he needs.
Why the double standard, you think?
Well, the double standard is because he can control that. He can control the uniform. Anything that's not deemed acceptable or part of the uniform in the NFL, no matter what it is, no matter how much it symbolizes, then you get fined. D'Angelo Williams lost his mother to breast cancer, so he decided he wanted to wear pink cleats the whole season, but you couldn't do that because the month of October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month in the NFL, so anytime you wear something pink outside of that, then you will get fined, which to me is ridiculous.
Yeah, I'm calling bull stat.
Why is
because
that?
If you look at Jay Cutler, he's on a hot streak right now. He's completing 66% of his passes. He has 8 touchdowns and 2 interceptions. And the biggest stat for me is the Green Bay Packers are 0-2 on the road. Where's that game?
Chicago.
It's in Chicago. Aaron Rodgers, the Green Bay Packers, they have problems. The Bears are moving the ball. They can run the ball. And even when they don't run the ball, they got those two beasts on the outside. Come on now. That's bull stat. Go ahead.